Oh, are we going? Oh, okay. Hi there, and welcome to the MCTV Sports Year in Review. I'm Josh Clark, and I'll be your conductor today as we travel back through the 2017-2018 sports year here at MC. But with summer on the horizon, here's a joke to lighten the dreary finals mood. Where do sharks go on summer vacation? Finland. Ha! I should probably get out more. But I'll be here all week. Just kidding, I'm actually leaving in the next day or two. But I'm still here now, and we've got plenty of sports and teams to recap, so let's dive right in. It's been another intriguing year for Choctaw Athletics. There were some highs and there were some lows, but through it all, we witnessed an entertaining year from the football fields to the basketball courts to the baseball and softball diamonds and everywhere in between. So let's take a look at everything that went down. We'll start by going way back to August 31st, 2017. The Mississippi College Choctaw football team trekked over to Atlanta, Georgia to kick off their 2017 regular season against Clark Atlanta University. It was their second season as full-time members of the Gulf South Conference, and they were looking to improve on their three-season win from 2016. But after a heartbreaking 32-29 overtime loss to Clark Atlanta, the Choctaws hit a rough patch. MC lost the first 8 games of their season and had trouble getting their defense and offense on the same page. It's not to say they didn't have some close calls, though. The Choctaws lost 30-17 to number 13 Delta State in their second home game of the year in late September and had the GSC on upset watch through the first half of the game. 1 week later, they lost 28-14 on the road to West Florida, who eventually advanced to the NCAA Division II championship. The wins just didn't fall in their favor. But it wasn't all rain clouds and sadness. The Choctaws pulled out their first win on Senior Day on November 4th in front of a home crowd. They defeated Shorter University 30-29 on a last-second field goal from the leg of Greg Nichols. It was a bright spot in their final home game of the year that helped them close it out with a bang. All in all, the Choctaws finished 1-9 on the season. A notable player throughout the year was freshman wide receiver Darius Young, who was named to the D2 CCA All-Super Region 2 first team. And even though the NFL draft was the other night, there's still a hole in our hearts. But before you know it, college football will be back. The Choctaws begin their 2018 season on August 30th at home against Clark Atlanta and will look to split the series and start their season on a high note. With new schemes being implemented, new coach Tommy Laurendine taking over the offensive coordinator position, and new recruits coming in, who knows where the Choctaws may go next year. One thing is for sure, the Choctaws are still on the move. Moving on to just outside Robinson-Hale Stadium and into A.E. Wood Coliseum, let's talk some volleyball now. The Lady Choctaws volleyball team fronted a good bit of young talent in their lineup this year, and while that speaks highly of their future, it did come with some growing pains. The volleyball team finished the year 10-22, including 2-14 against the GSC. Head coach Julie Reed has stepped down midway through the season and was replaced by interim head coach Holly Tupper. But 2018 could see a big turnaround for the Lady Choctaws. Shauna Laurendine, the wife of the newest offensive coordinator for the MC football team, has taken over the head coaching role for the volleyball team. And with 9 players returning from last season, there's plenty of potential still on the table. We'll have to wait until late August or early September to see what's next in the MC volleyball story. And now we move to cross country. The men's and women's cross-country teams also turned in successful seasons between September and November. The men's team earned first place honors in multiple competitions and finished the GSC championship in fourth place while also finishing 13th in the NCAA South Region championship. The women's team consistently finished in the top 4 throughout the regular season and claimed fifth place in the GSC championship before finishing 9th overall in the South Region. Things continue to look up for our Choctaw runners. Finally, let's get to the fall sport that just did not stop for MC, soccer. The men's soccer team finished the season with a record of 11-3-3, including 7-2-2 in GSC play. They were ranked at different points in the season and really turned up the heat in the middle of the season with 7 wins in a row. They won their first match of the GSC tournament against West Florida before losing in a 1-0 match to Alabama Huntsville. That loss kept them just outside of the NCAA Division II playoffs, but it doesn't take away from their successful season overall. And with a heap of returning talent from all across the globe, look to the Choctaw men's soccer team to make some more waves starting early next semester. The women's team, on the other hand, was pretty spectacular. The Lady Choctaws took the soccer world by storm, finishing with a 15-4-1 record, including a 12-2 mark in GSC play, and an undefeated record on their home field here in Clinton. And the individual performances were just as impressive. Junior Lauren Smith had defenses reeling as she led all Lady Choctaws in goals with 9. Caitlin Hayes was named to the United Soccer Coaches NCAA D2 All-America First Team, the D2 CCA All-America Honorable Mention Team, and a bunch of other teams that I don't have the breath to list out. Andrea McDonald turned in an incredible year in the box, giving up just 9 goals through 16 games, and picked up her 24th career shutout to set a new MC program record. So yeah, they were pretty good. The Lady Choctaws won their first 2 games of the GSC tournament and narrowly lost a 1-0 match in the finals to Lee. They still earned themselves a spot in the D2 playoffs, but were unfortunately knocked out in their first match by West Florida in a 1-0 finish. That by no means diminishes all of the amazing things that the Lady Choctaws did this season, though, and it leaves the door open for so much excitement and potential in 2018. September can't get here quick enough, that's for sure. To close out fall sports, let's talk about golf. Yes, I know they were just competing last week, but they also played in the fall, so why not talk about them now? The Choctaws played in 4 different tournaments in the fall, placing 17th, 9th, 8th, and 6th. They played in 4 more this semester, placing 7th, 5th, 6th, and 8th. Sophomore Force Choi from Macau, China, took to the spotlight this season as well, as he posted a 207 at the MC Spring Invitational, which marked the lowest 54-hole total in MC school history. Now that's impressive. They finished out their year at the GSC Championship with a 9th place finish. But as the temperatures outside began to drop and both hot coffee and hot chocolate became commodities, that coffee's gone bad, there was no more time for enjoying outdoor sports. And so we transitioned to MC winter sports. First up, of course, we have Choctaw basketball. After falling just short of the GSC tournament last season, the Lady Choctaws basketball team returned to AE Wood Coliseum looking for more. That dream unfortunately did not come to fruition. MC started out of the gate playing 500 basketball and sat at a record of 4-4 by the time finals week hit. But as the GSC competition got deeper and more skilled, it pushed the Lady Choctaws into a tight spot. MC lost 7 of the 8 contests to start the new year and could not recover as they finished the season 9-17, including a 5-15 mark against the Gulf South Conference. They finished in 11th place overall. But it wasn't a bad year to rebuild. MC saw impressive progress from a few different freshmen on their roster, including center Lauren Sheriff, who led the team in points scored and blocks. Sheriff was one of a handful of freshmen that saw extensive playing time with the Lady Choctaws down the stretch and put their skills in the spotlight. With a solid group of 11 girls returning to the team next year, it's safe to say, hashtag trust the process. Only time will tell, though. The Choctaw men's basketball team, however, kept things interesting for a while. The Choctaws started out at a strong pace at the beginning of the season, which included a last-second loss to Christian Brothers, who was number 10 in the nation at that point, in their second GSC game of the year. They were led by their usual group of talent in veterans Antonio Johnson, Stacey Mack, and Xavion Dillon. But as the season rolled along, their path through the GSC tournament shifted considerably. Stacey Mack and Isaiah Austin were deemed ineligible for the rest of the season following the first semester, which meant that the Choctaws needed their younger guns to step up. And boy did they. Junior forward Donovan Hamm helped lead the charge on offense throughout the season and ended the year with the most points of any Choctaw on the team. Not bad for his first year with MC, huh? Close behind him was sophomore forward Brandon Boston, who stepped up in a big way, and by big I mean like 6'5" big, down the stretch. He became the Choctaws' primary player in the paint alongside freshman John Harding and sophomore Tucker Campbell. The Choctaws were in the thick of the GSC tournament race up until late January, but after a few losses that snowballed into 8 straight to close out the year, MC finished the year 9-16, including 6-14 in the conference. They finished in a tie for 10th place in the GSC and fell short of the tournament. But with a young talent that showed itself off this past season and that will return for the 2018-19 year, there's plenty to be excited about in the future of Choctaw basketball. And hey, AE Wood Coliseum did get a pretty sweet Jumbotron in February. Next up, let's talk about the MC table tennis team. If you didn't already know, yes, we actually do have a table tennis team, and they are good, like really good. The table tennis team went to nationals this semester and competed with 49 other schools. They finished in third place after narrowly losing to NYU. The team believed it was a good wake-up call to see that other teams are getting better and prepares to bounce back next year and reach for the national championship. What a year it was for the athletes from Alumni Gym. The men's and women's track and field teams also got underway in the winter and are now finishing up action. The men's team picked up a first place finish earlier in the semester, as well as one in early April, and also picked up a few third and fourth place finishes as well. In the GSC Outdoor Championships, the men's team finished fifth. They have the Southern Miss Open on Saturday, April 28th, before heading for the NCAA Division II National Outdoor Championships. But I'll be on the road to Texas before those results come in, so make sure to keep up with the team on GoChoctaws.com. The women's team finished the year with similar results. They turned in a few second and fourth place finishes and closed out the GSC Outdoor Championships in sixth place. But let me take a moment here just to talk about Andrea McDonald. This girl was the superstar goalkeeper of the Lady Choctaw soccer team in the fall and immediately bounced over to track and field following the season. And if you didn't already know, she's earned plenty of GSC honors this season, including GSC Co-Field Athlete of the Year and two, count them, two gold medals and one silver medal at the GSC Championships. Now that is dedication, and it deserves a round of applause. So Andrea, cheers to you. But as the cold mistress winter exited and spring sprung here at MC, the baseball and softball teams took to their diamonds. And for the first time in a while, both were on fire. Not literally, of course, but figuratively. We've been talking about the baseball team all season here at MCTV as they continue to impress and turn heads around the GSC and D2 as a whole. In March of 2017, the MC baseball team sat at a mark of 2-18 and looked to be in for another disastrous year. But dang it if they didn't pull off one of the most incredible turnarounds in MC sports history. After rallying and qualifying for the GSC tournament last season as an 8 seed, the Choctaws are back for more this year, but their sights and aspirations are much higher than before. MC is currently 28-13 on the year with a record of 17-8 against GSC opponents. They started the year off with a record of 14-2 and were even nationally ranked for a short period. Their first series against the GSC opponent was a 2-1 victory over number 9 West Georgia. Everything that could go right for the Choctaws did go right, and it still is for the most part. MC currently sits in fourth place in the GSC and already has a tournament berth locked up. Seven Choctaws are hitting over 300 in the batting order, including Blaine Krim and Billy Cameron, who've combined for 14 home runs this year. On the mound, names like Chris Crosby, Hunter Mullis, Zach Ingram, and Brandon Kennedy are all turning heads and throwing strikes. All in all, it's been an incredible year for MC baseball. They'll close it out on the road on April 28th and 29th in Cleveland, Mississippi against that green team, Delta State, who currently sits in first in the GSC. It'll be a big test and a great measuring stick series before the tournament begins. So from all of us at MCTV, good luck, baseball team. We're all counting on you. But they aren't the only ones we're counting on. The MC softball team is doing just as good of a job right now and is looking for their second straight GSC tournament title. That may look to be a bit more of a challenge than it was last year, but if we know anything about this Lady Choctaw softball team, it is that there are no limits on their potential. MC's 26-14 on the softball diamond this year, including a 17-11 mark against the GSC. They've won 10 of their past 13 games and are making a serious run to close out the year. Eight Lady Choctaws are batting over 300. Kristen Qualls hit her 28th home run this year, which now puts her in first place in MC history in the home run category. Adriana Morgan and Corey Cooper are having terrific years on the mound, but every Lady Choctaw is doing her part in this late surge. MC's fourth in the GSC right now with one series against that green team before their regular season ends. They have also clinched a spot in the GSC tournament. Could they pick up another championship banner? Let's hope so. Good luck to our softball team as well in their post-semester endeavors. Once again, we're all counting on you. And to close this whole mega show out, let's talk about our tennis teams. The men's tennis team started play on February 13th and started the season out with a record of 4-1. But after four losses in a row against GSC opponents to open conference play, they found themselves in a bind. They finished a year 8-10 with a 3-8 mark against the GSC, and they missed the tournament on a tiebreaker, but still built up plenty of potential for next year. Now let's talk about this incredible women's team. The Lady Choctaw's tennis squad turned in the kind of year that you only see in movies or with Alabama football. In other words, they were nearly perfect in the regular season. MC finished the regular season with a record of 18-1, with their only loss coming against nationally ranked West Florida. You need them to beat number 20 Mobile? They got it. You need them to start the season on a 14-game win streak? No problem. You need them to coast through the GSC tournament up until a hard-fought loss in the championship against West Florida? They can do that too. And now they're heading for the NCAA Division II championships for the first time in program history. They will take on West Florida in the first round and hope that the third time is the charm on Saturday, April 28th. Once again, our studio will be pretty much deserted at that point, so keep up with the Lady Choctaws on social media or on GoChoctaws.com to see just how far they can go. And for the third time, good luck, Lady Choctaws. We're all counting on you. So yeah, it's been a pretty fun year in the Choctaw sports world after all. From records broken to last-second victories and even some agonizing defeats, the 2017-2018 school year was one to remember for MC Athletics. And with that, we look to the future. It's promising to be a good one for a lot of teams, and that's about all we can ask for at this point. But before all that kicks off, make sure to enjoy your summer vacations. And be safe, because only losers aren't safe. From all of us at MCTV and the sports side of the show, we'll see you in the fall. Happy summer!